Hello and welcome. This is Silverox, and on today's episode, we are going to be making the Sombra Machine Pistol from the game Overwatch. Now, this is going to be a bit of a different video when it comes to the assembly process. On this one, I made more of an effort to specifically determine the number and name for all the pieces. So while assembling this will be divided into several parts. The first is going to be the body, which is just this group right here. Going to be the grip, the stock, the barrel, and the individual accessories that are going to go all around this. Now, currently the mag is outside of the body because this is slottable in place and it will actually hold it considerably well, even needing a small amount of force to pull it out. Now the reason this isn't here because this is an incredibly big gun. As you can see, both of my hands can't even cover this up, and this stands at about a 35 centimeter long build. Now this does take a long time to assemble and to print, mostly just the printing parts. And that's why I won't be showing you any of the time lapses for the prints, because I just didn't have the patience to set up everything up as needed. As just, I believe, was this piece took about 3 hours to print, and after the cleaning and stuff, I made a video and I couldn't keep it, so I just discarded it. Now with that said, we are going to begin the process, but before, you can go to my Patreon page at patreon.com/silveroxcraft and you can get the SDL file for this. Now this, because they are a 3D printing model, will be set on the $5 pledge. But of course, this was a modification to a previous build I've made, which was the papercraft version, and you can get those at the $2 pledge. So thank you for coming for here and enjoying the rest of the video. So here we are going to start by building the body of the gun. Now the body is composed of pieces BDA all the way to BD3. Those stand for body A, B, C, D, and E. These are better displayed on the SCL files, so there's no reason to get lost on the build process. So to put this all together, we are going to be using a mixture of hot glue and the plastic adhesive. Now the plastic adhesive is going to be for larger surfaces. They are not as fragile to put together, as the hot glue is going to be for surfaces like this, which are smaller and they are harder to hold in place while gluing. So now we are going to put this piece aside and build in my order. So here we have pieces BDC and B no BDB and BDC. These two pieces are going to be set in this configuration, making sure that it is following the incline of the top parts of BDB, and of course gluing this together with the plastic adhesive. Now with these pieces we're going to set it aside and we are going to increase this BDA and BDB. Now these two are just going to be glued top to bottom like this, and then it will all be slotted into place, forming the complete body shape. This is the basis of the gun and this is where everything else is going to attach to. Now with the main body assembled, we're just going to get it out of the way, and right here we have pieces for the barrel, specifically BAA, BAB, and BAC. These all stand for barrel A, B, and C, of course. Now these are the easiest to assemble, as all they require is to slot the specific barrel pieces into the specific slots. Considering the top of the cover right here is what points to the top of the gun, so the bigger one is going to go on this slot and the smaller one on this. Now these ones are going to be glued with the glue gun because it's much easier than using the plastic adhesive. And there we go. This is the result. This is how it's going to eventually attach directly onto the body. Now I'm not going to do this now because I'm going to be adding specific pieces to both the top and the side. They're gonna help with the alignment of this piece. So like always, this is going to be set to the side, and I'm going to bring in the grip. Now the grip is distributed into 7 pieces, even though one of them is a standalone, which is not going to be attached to the grip, but I left it in the same group. These are going to be from the left to right: GA, GB, GC, GD, GE, GF, and GG. These pieces are obviously all going to be put together once again, except for this one, which will simply attach to the front of the body. So this one we can put aside right now, and we are going to grab, I believe this one is GD. Oh, sorry, GE and GF. Now these two pieces are just going to slot like this, but there is no alignment other than the hole for the magazine. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab part M, which once again is a standalone part, and I'm going to slot it into the bottom of the grip, allowing me to slot this piece all the way to the top. Now as you can see, part, I believe, GF has a much better grip on part M than part GE. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add and go to this. So once again, go to the process of slotting the magazine and slotting this over top, allowing the part GEF to go to part GE. Now that this is glued, we can still easily remove the magazine without it being glued to the pieces, but I will be leaving it this in place until this is completely dry. Now what I'm going to do is going to grab this assembly, and we're going to grab part GA. Now this one is simply going to attach here, but as you can see, this is a very small surface of contact. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave it aside, and I'm going to grab part GB. This one is going to be attached in the center right here, and this is going to be the trigger guard, as you can see. And this has a much higher surface contact, which will allow me to later on simply glue this in place with this extra surface contact in it. So I'm going to be putting that together. So part GB is now intact and in its place. I had to resort using the hot glue gun, as the plastic adhesive was not holding this in place as well as this. So as you can see, that's some squares out down there, but it's necessary because of the small surface contact. So now we can add part GA right there. Once again, we are going to have to resort to using some hot glue for this, because exactly as before, of the smaller surface contact. In the end, this is not going to be a major issue, since I'm adding small amounts of glue, it won't leave a huge gap between the parts. That's of course one of the bigger problems with the glue gun, is the gaps that the glue forms as you are squeezing it in. So it solidifies before it completely flat. So these are now in place, just making sure that this piece is already too late to move, but it's no problem because this is going to hide it. Now this is part GC, and this is simply a decorative piece. Now once again, this is one of my bigger problems, is I like to make these types of wheels in as many parts as possible. Instead of simply making this entire thing into one piece, which I could have done, since the printing support would have only been in the off of the grip and on the bottom, instead I decide to make this into seven, not counting this one, six different parts. So my bad, I guess, but it's the way I like to do things, so it will remain like that in the future as well. So finally we can just glue the grip, the trigger in place, and there we go. That is the grip fully assembled, and attaching it to the body is just as simple as slotting it in the bottom right here. Now making sure that this is in line with these outer pegs. Of course there's nothing to attach it to, but the relatively large glue surface should be more than enough to hold this entire thing in place in this position. Now the Summer's Machine Gun now taking place. As you can see, that was a bit of a cool separation of the parts right there. There's a bit of a gap. I found out that the top one right here actually warped. So this one didn't glue properly to that, and since I glued this entire thing directly to this piece, it was left with this slight gap. Now that's not much of a problem, but it's something you need to be careful with. Of course, the piece M can simply slot in place and give us the submachine piston with a full extended mag. Now I'm going to remove it because it's hard enough to keep this entire thing on screen as it is without adding this piece. So this is going to go to the side, and we are going to be grabbing the last piece of that's on the grip group. This is GG, yeah, nice name for it. So we are just going to add glue to this, and it goes straight on the front right here, giving us the secondary grip for the gun. So once again, we are going to be setting this to the side, and we now going to be working on the stock part. So right here we have parts SDA and SDB, which stands for stock A and B. Now these are very simple. There is a slot on the back of SDA, which STV simply slots into. So this is going to be the configuration we are going to be leaving it, and then we are going to be gluing it directly onto this slot on the back of the body. So now to add these two pieces into place is easy. Just slide it upward and apply some force, and it will simply go inside. Now the spacing here is quite tight. As you can see, it requires some force to slide into it, but ultimately that will give us a better support structure for the stock. So as you can see, that is the stock piece attached to the body. This is turning out to be one of the bigger guns I've built, but in the end I will show you a size comparison with previous ones I have, so you can determine for yourself. So the last group we have to assemble is the sights. Now the sights are composed of SEA and SEB. These two are very simple to attach. It's just going to be the bottom surface of SEB is going to glue onto the top of SEA, just like that. So with the sights now assembled, we can bring in the rest of the miscellaneous pieces. Now this one is ACC, I believe. So I know it's just piece AC, which is for an accessory, and this is piece R, which is the rail. Now these are the two pieces we are going to use as alignment to properly fit the barrel into place. So putting this aside, bringing in the body. Obviously the rail is the easiest piece to attach, as it just goes on the top, making sure that it is properly centered, just like that. And piece AC just goes on the front right here, once again, making sure that the, let me grab this a different way so I don't disturb the camera, these two surfaces are aligned, since this is where the bottom of the barrel is going to attach to, and this surface right here is going to grab onto the side of the on the surface right here on the barrel. Of course, this lip right here is what's going to attach on the top, and that's going to serve as the top alignment and the lateral alignment. So I'm going to be adding these two pieces in place. So here we had to make a bit of an angle change so I could actually display this entire thing on screen. As you can see, it's turning out to be incredibly big, and it's still not fully assembled. So since we have the two guide pieces in place, we can just slot the barrel in place, and it will hold center just like this. And with that, all we need to do is add the magazine, and we'll have the full size Sombras machine pistol completely assembled. Now, as you can see, this is my hand, sorry about that, this is my hand next to the gun itself. Now it may not seem that big, but here is Mercy's Caduceus Blaster next to Sombra's machine pistol. Now, this is currently set against the back of the stock. As you can see, the huge space that's left on the front right here, and this is already a considerably big gun. And of course, the one previous to that, this is the Volter pistol, and setting this to the top is in the bottom, like the Caduceus Blaster, you can see the huge amount of space that's still left on the front. This is officially the biggest gun I have built, and it's so big that I can't actually get it all on frame without bumping into something. As you can see, the magazine itself has to be left outside of the picture because of the size of this. So this was, of course, the Sombra's machine pistol from the game Overwatch. Like I said in the beginning of the video, this is going to be set on my $5 Patreon pledge because of the, this is a 3D printing model, so the STL file will be there, but you can still get the papercraft model of this, which is an identical version to this. The only difference is the barrels just glue onto the surface of this instead of going inside. Pretty much everything else is an identical replica of this, including its size. Just if you are curious, I have a ruler here, and this sets at 35 centimeters long. If you can see that, it sets at 25 centimeters long. That's how big this is. Literally the biggest gun I've built. And of course, I forgot to add this piece. I was so worried about getting this done as soon as possible that I completely forgot to add the sights on. Of course, I hope you enjoyed watching the video. I had a little bit of a different take on this video. I tried to separate every part into a specific piece, either numbering and naming them. But ultimately, this was one of the more time-consuming pieces just to build. Now, I didn't show you any of the 3D printing process. You can see on the back that's a 3D printer right here. I did not show you that because just some of these pieces took almost 3 hours to build. Now I could have made them with a different nozzle and a different layer size, but I wanted it to be as clean as possible, as I do like to keep these. As you can see, this one was built without any sanding necessary. This one not so much, because I recently changed the nozzle because I messed up my previous one, and I still they haven't got everything, all the settings completely right. As you can see, this one is the only piece which I have not sanded. You can see this one is sanded. If you just paint this will go completely flat. But as you can see, there's a lot of lines showing here. As on this one, for example, not so much. Even this one, which was printing on this orientation, there's not that many lines showing. So, like I said, if you like this, you can go to my Patreon at patreon.com/silverrockscraft. You can get both the STL files for this, which will be on the $5 pledge, or the papercraft version of this, which will be on the $2 pledge. With that said, thank you, and I hope you have a nice day.